Good morning and a warm welcome. Today is an important day and we look forward to sharing some exciting news with you. Over the years, Sweden and Microsoft have developed a strong partnership, not only by Microsoft providing Swedish companies technology and expertise to develop and grow, but also through acquisitions where Swedish innovations have become a central part of the company's global offering. Sweden is truly a front runner in many areas, such as sustainability, innovation, and gender equality. These values are also fundamental pillars in Microsoft's culture, and we see a strong fit between the company and Sweden as a country. Today, we're excited to tell you more about a significant commitment for Microsoft in digital transformation in Sweden, designed to support the country's growth. We are thrilled to announce that Microsoft has selected Sweden to establish two data center regions in Gävle-Sandviken and in Staffanstorp. This will be one of the world's most advanced sustainable data center designs, perfectly matching the country's strong commitment to sustainability and innovation. Microsoft has invested in a range of community projects in the cities of Gävle, Sandviken and Staffanstorp, which are part of the data center regions. Microsoft is also advancing its work with the SkillUp Sweden initiative, which aims to provide digital skilling opportunities for 150,000 Swedes to strengthen their technical competence and build on Microsoft's recently announced initiative to help 25 million people acquire new digital skills globally. Microsoft has selected Sweden as the site for one of its most advanced sustainable data center designs due to the country's strong commitment to sustainability and innovation. We are looking forward to having the new data center regions available in 2021.
Trust in the Microsoft Cloud is based on a trust and verify model. So Microsoft is one of the world's most compliant IT platforms with more than 90 compliance offerings, ranging from GDPR to regional, national, or ISO security standards. So these compliance standards are then validated by third parties to ensure that Microsoft complies with them. On the topic of data residency, the Microsoft Cloud in Sweden will be one of the largest data centers in this region, with full redundancy between several data centers to make it possible to provide data residency at rest in Sweden. Microsoft has made a commitment to become carbon negative by 2030. What does that mean? Well, carbon negative means that we will remove more carbon dioxide than we are adding to the environment. And by 2050, we commit to remove all of the carbon dioxide that we have emitted since the company was founded. Our data center strategy is, of course, a very important part of that commitment. And we are running on 100% renewable energy, we are planning for zero waste, and we're implementing new innovative technologies like the 24/7 matching solution to be able to verify the energy mix in the data centers.
The way this 24/7 solution works is that we measure consumption by the hour rather than by the month or by the day. That is what we typically do otherwise. And that way we can make sure that we check the consumption every hour and then we match that with production the same hour. And that way we can check whether a certain wind farm or a hydro plant is running, and we can make a physical connect between the consumption in the Microsoft data center and the production of electricity in a wind farm or a hydro dam. So there is a real connect between consumption and production. is a super important step in creating a tool so that the entire market eventually will work even in a completely fossil-free environment.
At Accenture, we see cloud as a key foundation and a driver for digitalization and competitiveness. The cloud platforms today have built-in capabilities, whether it's around security, whether it's around data, whether it's around analytics, whether it's around automations. So when you're moving to the cloud, you're in a sense tapping in to the R&D budget of Microsoft. Swedish-based cloud data centers will be vitally important for many organizations. I think especially in the public sector and financial services. So I truly believe that this will have an enormous potential, not only for the cities where the centers are being opened up in Staffanstorp and Sandviken and in Gävle, but also for Sweden as a whole and for our European market. Through this, we will enable data security, data compliance, and a path to sustainable digital transformation.
Good morning, Sverige. I hope everyone is safe and well. It is my pleasure to talk with you today and be part of this exciting news. Microsoft has had a long-term commitment with Sweden. We indeed opened one of our very first international operations in Sweden more than 35 years ago. And since that day, we've been developing great partnership with 3,000 partners, but also public-private companies and the public sector, and supporting local communities. And we do that to empower people and organizations to achieve more in Sweden. I had the pleasure to visit Sweden a number of times over the past 20 years, and I would love to come back whenever I can travel freely. What I love in particular about Sweden is the way the country has established such a great leadership when it comes to sustainability, innovation, and gender equity. And now, these days, we are partnering even more closely with Sweden and the EU altogether to truly help recovering from the impact of COVID-19 and help building a more inclusive and a more sustainable future. We see enormous potential to support economic recovery and accelerate digital transformation in Sweden by investing in the local ecosystem. These new data centers will provide local companies with enterprise-grade cloud services and world-class innovation and serve customers all across Europe but also around the world. There will be two of the most advanced sustainable data centers we've ever designed as a company, and the first to use the Vattenfall 24/7 matching solution, along with power from 100% renewable energy, plans as well for zero waste operations, and an ambition of achieving zero carbon operations. You know, these data center regions will further our broader commitment to creating a sustainable low-carbon future for all. I'm very proud of the work Microsoft Sweden team has done to partner with leading Swedish customers and support their digital transformation journeys. Customers like Sandvik Koromant, that is leveraging the cloud to shape the future of manufacturing and achieving ambitious sustainability targets in the process. Partnership as well with organizations like Accenture, and enabling a wide range of local communities to take full advantage of cloud and AI technologies. Our plan to help support the digital skills of more than 150,000 citizens will empower more Swedes to take advantage of the employability opportunities these investments will bring. Microsoft is committed to the bright digital future being built in Sweden, and we are here to provide our contribution. To all of you and your loved ones, stay safe and well. Tusen tack.
A data center establishment of this size will fuel the ecosystem of already existing companies, but also to accelerate the startup community. This will lead to that we will have an increased demand and skilled IT and tech competences. That's why we will invest jointly in collaboration with organizations like Rapatak, Kodcentrum, but also the municipalities of Sandviken, Gävle and Staffanstorp in local education programs for IT certifications.
With today's announcement, we look forward to beginning a new part of our journey here in Sweden, where together we can create new possibilities through digitalization.